The CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents... Come in. Welcome. I'm E.G. Marshall. Today, when we say the United States... we mean 50 of them, all the way from Florida to Alaska, from Maine to Hawaii. It's hard to remember that little over a century ago, there were only 35 states, most of them east of the Mississippi River. Even our most devastating war, the Civil War, or the war between the states, was fought in only half of our land area. The rest was still wilderness, split into territories like the Northwest, the Louisiana, and the one where our story takes place, the Colorado Territory.
Bring them back, driver! This is a holdup!
Yeah, what's going on? Which side is it on? My side, Mr. Randall.
I missed him. Both barrels.
Watch out, you clumsy fool! You're in my way!
It's too late, Mr. Randall. He's got us dead to rights. You might as well give up or get your head shot off.
Mystery drama, The Finger of God, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Ian Martin and stars Kristoffer Tabori. I'll be back shortly with Act One. Don't look for the town of Brush Mound, Colorado on the map. You won't find it. It's long since gone, erased by an interstate highway. But although there wasn't all that much of it to begin with, in 1860, it was pretty important to the cowhands, the cattlemen, and a scattering of local farmers. All the commerce of the region was conducted there because J.B. Randall owned everything you could see from horseback in any direction. He also owned the local store, the bank, and what's more important, everyone who traded there. J.B. Randall was an emperor. And next to his town, his proudest possession was his daughter, Carrie.
Quiet, Midnight. I'm listening for something. Jazz? Jazz? You hear him too, Midnight? All right, Chad, I'm here. Pull up.
Bear to your right a piece. I'm right over here in this little clearing.
Oh, Carrie, I thought you were never coming.
I shouldn't have, and I can only stay a minute. I said I was just going for a short canter. Once I got behind the tree line, I lit out for this place.
All that matters is you're here.
No, Chad, don't. That's over.
What do you mean, over?
I mean you and me.
Well, then why did you send for me to meet you here today?
To tell you, and to ask you not to make any trouble.
Oh, Carrie, you ain't afraid of me.
I'm afraid for you.
You mean your father?
He'd have you gunned down if you tried to stop it.
Oh, I'm not afraid of J.B. Randall. Well, what do you mean, tried to stop it?
I'm going to be married.
When?
This Saturday.
Who? Oh, now, darn it, Carrie, to who?
Abe Pullen.
Abe Pullen? That fat old horn toad? He's old enough to be your father, Carrie. Now, you can't.
Chad, I've got to. I'm promised.
By your father. It isn't you, Carrie. Now, you couldn't do that.
What difference does it make? It's the way it's gonna be.
No, I won't let it happen.
You can't stop it.
Well, you could run away with me.
Where?
My brother Rusty and me. Now, we've been talking about pulling up stakes anyways.
How far do you think we'd get? My daddy'd just have us hunted down, kill you and Rusty and drag me home.
Don't you love me enough to take a chance?
I love you too much to take a chance on your life.
What life am I ever going to have without you? There's got to be a way, Carrie.
No, darling. It just ain't meant for us.
No. I'm never going to let you get away from me.
No way. You can hold on to me the way things are. I love you. But like I said in the beginning, that's over.
never really had a chance, little brother. You knew her pappy wouldn't ever let her hitch up with no small account trash like us.
We're not small account trash, Rusty.
On J.B. Randall's spread, we are. Don't you ever forget it.
Our family's just as good as his.
Maybe. Whole trouble is we ain't as rich. So far.
What does that mean?
I've been studying something about us, little brother. Now, we got some cash money put by, but it ain't more than could buy us a pokey little homesteader's land. What we want to get us is at least a section and enough cattle to stock it.
We ain't got that kind of money.
No, but old J.B. has. And I figure he owes us a little of it.
What for?
Lots of reasons. First off, you're too young maybe to remember, but he squeezed our pappy off his own land right here in Brush Mound. More than that, I'll never believe it was Injuns, Bushwhack Paul. It was J.B.'s hired hands. Now he's cut his daughter off from you. Enough reasons to believe he owes us a little something, don't you think?
The only thing we'd get free out of him is a bullet in the back.
The only thing we'd get. But how's about what we just take? Shouldn't every gal come with a dowry?
What are you talking?
Well, you know what I'm talking. Now, J.B. foreclosed on poor old Piedmont and is buying him out. Now, you're riding into Leadville tomorrow by coach so you can sit shotgun on the way back.
We're bringing back Strongbox?
Cash on the barrelhead to pay off all the Piedmont ranch hands and all the other debts. You're riding shotgun, so when I turn up with my mask and haul you down, you make sure the driver don't reach for his gun.
We're gonna rob the stage? It's too risky. We can't get away with it in his territory.
Don't be too sure.
He'll follow us.
If he's able. It's a big country out there onto the west.
Oh, yeah, but there's so few ways we can pass over the mountains.
That's my ace in the hole.
What?
It's like our luck was running right. Know who I just run into when I was picking you up from town? Lone Beaver. He brought in a pack of pelts and unloaded them. He's headed back up north again. Chad, boy, he is just what we need.
I know you and he are old friends, but I...
Chad, that old Injun is one man knows this country like the back of your hand. Now, he's got trails through the forests and up over the mountains no white man knows about. And he owes me one favor he's got to repay. His life. He's our passport to safety. With J.B.'s money and his daughter.
I just don't know about robbing a stage.
Now, look. You want Carrie Randall for your wife, don't you?
Chad, you up there, boy? You hear me?
Yeah, I hear you, Mr. Randall.
I hope you see better than you hear. Now, you keep your eyes peeled good on that shotgun cock. This stage is going right on through. Anyone tries to stop it, you give them both barrels before you ask why.
Yes, sir. You carrying a gun, Mr. Randall?
Of course I am. You know I never go anywhere unarmed. Why?
Oh, I just wanted to make sure, sir. You know...
Which side is he on?
My side. And I missed him. Both barrels.
Well, what are you climbing down for? Get away from the door, boy. I can't get a shot at him.
Look out, sir. I'm coming in before he shoots me.
Well, watch out, you clumsy fool. You're in my way.
I'm sorry. I lost my foot.
You knocked the gun out of my hand. Where is it?
I think it went under the seat.
All right, driver. Climb on down. Just leave your gun where it is. You, inside. Listen close, you hear? I got a can of powder in my hand with a short fuse. Now, y'all climb out empty-handed before I count to three, or I'm lighting the fuse and tossing it in there.
Better do as he says.
I had my gun.
Yeah, I think when we come to a full stop, it fell out the door.
One, two...
Take it easy. We're coming out.
That's right. Now, keep your hands up. Anyone else in there?
No. Look, I don't know who you are. But if you know who I am, you know you can't get away with this.
Oh, I know who you are, all right, Mr. Randall. That's the reason I stopped you. You got a strong box inside there that I want after I've tied you up. Now, come on, let's all of us just mosey over to that tree there.
You touch that money and I'll have a posse after your hide to lynch you for sure. I own this town, I own the sheriff, and I...
And you have a big mouth. You don't shut it for yourself, I will. Now, move. Yes, sir. I got all the money snug as you please in my saddlebags. Wasn't much of a lock on the box. Blew it off the first shot.
You won't get far with that money.
Oh, I don't know. It's coming on dock already. It might be quite a piece before anyone comes across you. Just wanted to say thanks. And, so long. Yay-hoo!
I'll catch up with you. You... Ted, can you get your hands loose?
Not yet, but I'm working on it.
What about the driver?
Oh, he's still out, sir.
Dead?
Oh, no, sir. Just a lump on his head. Russ, I mean, the rustler. The rustler must have knocked him out.
Would you tell me just what in the Sam Hill happened?
Well, a fellow came out of the trees behind us. I took a shot at him. But he came around the other side of the stage, so my second shot missed him, too.
How come the driver didn't fire?
When I reached over him to take my second shot, I reckon I must have knocked the gun out of his hand.
Same as you did with me. Whose side are you on?
Oh, I'm yours, sir. Yours.
Why in tarnation did you have to come down off the box?
Well, that fellow was shooting at me, and I thought if I could get your gun, we might have a chance to get him.
That you clumsy young fool. I'll take care of you later. First off, let's get loose and get after that thief.
Yes? Who is it?
It's Chad's brother, Miss Randall. Rusty.
What do you want?
I gotta talk to you. Something mighty important. Could you come on out a minute?
What's so important?
Well, I can't tell you. Here, it's about Chad.
I'll meet you down by the barn. But I can't run away with Chad.
You don't love him enough?
Of course I do. That's why I can't. My daddy wouldn't stand still for it.
Well, nobody's asking him. He wouldn't be here.
He'd track us down.
Not the way we're going.
If I run, I can't even bring Chad a dowry.
Well, supposing I was to tell you. You already have.
What? How?
Miss Randall, Carrie, I'm going to put everything right in your hands. Less than an hour ago, I robbed the stage your pa was on. And I got the money he was carrying in my saddlebags. I talked Chad into going along with it because it was the only chance he could have to have you. That's all he wants in this world.
That's what you meant by my dowry?
Well, that's about it, ma'am.
But now, more than ever, J.B. will be after us.
Not more than ever, Carrie. J.B. Randall's got two things rules his life. You and money. Whether we got one or both, he's still going to be after us. I'm just asking you which side you want to be on. The hunted or the hunter? Or to put it another way, how much do you love my little brother, Chad?
The girl faces the intense young man before her, her pupils wide in the dark stable, not only against the light, but the enormity of her decision. Does she dare feed her father's fury? Or have Rusty and Chad already driven J.B. Randall so far that the die is cast anyway, and she might as well risk all for love? I shall return shortly with Act Two. In the steadily darkening night, her ears attuned to the familiar sounds of the stable and her home, Carrie Randall is wrestling in her mind with an enormous decision. To hang on to her protected and sheltered life, or to run with the man she loves, knowing that he, at least in the eyes of the law, is an outlaw. Worst of all, that circumstances dictate she cannot make the decision directly. She must make it secondhand.
Why isn't Chad here to ask me himself?
Well, it's the way I told you, Carrie. He had to have some protection when we robbed the stage. He's out there tied up with your daddy and the driver.
Then how do we go together?
Well, whatever you decide, I take off from here to a meeting place. Chad's going to join me there, I hope.
Then I'm coming with you, Rusty, no matter what. How do we manage it?
Chad can get out of the ropes anytime he wants. We figured he'd wait till dusk anyways, unless someone comes across him. And that could make it a little tight. As soon as your pa gets back here, you know he's going to round up a posse to go track the robber.
He doesn't know it was you?
No, I had a gunny sack over my head and a horse cut from the range. Chances are he wouldn't know who I am.
So how's he going to track you?
Soft or hard underfoot, clear prairies or thick woods. Anyone on horseback leaves some kind of trail.
But once Daddy is freed, how can we get away?
That's when we got our chance. Now, I laid a straight trail from where I left them tied up to the southwest until I got the hard trail and could circle back. You, me, and Chad are going northwest.
But you can't. You'd have to go straight up over old Baldy.
That's right.
There's no way anyone can pick his way across there above the tree line.
There's an old engine way, Carrie. And I got the man who's going to lead us over it. We make it, we're going to get lost eventually in Nevada territory. And when we do, there ain't nobody, not even your pappy's going to find us there.
Where do I meet you? When? And what do I bring?
Well, you be ready from here in. Chad knows where to rendezvous with me. We can't bring much more than a good horse, gear, and yourself.
Not even a wedding gown?
If it can fit in your saddlebags.
Oh, Rusty, am I doing the right thing?
Carrie, you are Chad's whole world.
I just hope I don't bring it tumbling about his ears.
No, my hands are tied for sure. I can't budge this rawhide. Can you, Chad?
Yes, sir, Mr. Randall. I think I just about got my hands free.
Then work at it, boy. I don't want that no good thieving polecat to cold trail us. I want his hide. Chad.
Yes, sir.
Did you notice anything familiar about that gunman?
Familiar, Mr. Randall?
You think he might have been someone you ever saw before?
Well, he had a sack over his head. How could I tell?
By his shape, his voice, the way he moved around. Couldn't you tell if you might have known him?
No, sir, Mr. Randall. I sure couldn't tell, no way. The
more I think on that, he had to be someone from around here. Someone who knew I was bringing in that cash money today.
Well, there, I'm loose. You don't have to study on that anymore. Let me untie you, sir.
Hey, come on, boy. Just get me my hands free so I can get them on that thief. Sheriff, I want you to round up about 20 good guns. The hardest boys you got to shoot first and talk later.
You got him, J.B.
I want this guy and I want him bad.
We'll get him for you. You gonna ride with us?
Sure am. Just as soon as I see my daughter and tell her what's up.
Rusty, that you, Chad? You alone? Where's Carrie?
Don't you worry none. She's right here.
Oh, Carrie.
Oh, Chad, my darling.
Okay, lovebirds. Now, there's no time for that. We got to hit the trail. Now, wait. First off, let me make sure. You know what you're getting into, Carrie?
You know what you're getting into? Stealing me away from my daddy?
It ain't the first thing we've stolen from him.
You forget that money. It's as much mine as his.
And you?
I'm all yours. I always have been and always will be.
Well, then, come on. Let's ride on out. Now, where do we meet Lone Beaver, Rusty? By Blue Rock, right at the approach to the divide. You sure now we can make it up over old Boldy?
Oh, if Lone Beaver says we can, we'll make it.
How much lead time you figure we have?
Take the posse a good hour to get back to where I held up the stage. Picking up the trail by dark won't be so easy. And if they follow the false one I left, it'll be another hour till they figure they've been skunked. After that, it's only a matter of time till J.B. finds Carrie missing. Then the fat'll really be in the fire.
Jason! Sheriff?
Yes, sir, J.B. Got the posse all ready to take after your hold-up man.
Oh, forget him right now. My daughter is missing, and so is that no-good ranch hand of mine, Chad Roberts, and his brother, Rusty. I got a hunch I'm being sidewinded here.
Well, how come, sir?
How come? Because only someone here on the spread knew I was bringing in that money today. And how come Chad missed two shots at the robber and knocked the gun out of the driver's hand to say nothing of the gun out of mine? How come Carrie's been taking on so about a good marriage I arranged for her? I won't tell you, I can see the whole thing right now. I've been taken.
Taken?
For a sucker. I knew there was something familiar about that hold-up man. I'd swear now on a stack of Bibles it was Rusty Roberts. And he and his no-count brother have taken off with not only my money, but my carry.
Well, then we better get after them, sir.
Yes, but where? Sheriff, I don't care where they went, north, south, east, or west. I want them Roberts brothers tracked down and spread-eagled in the desert, or hang from the nearest tree.
Come on, Chad. We got to keep moving to make our rendezvous with Lone Beaver.
We got to stop a minute. Water the horses. And Carrie's horse here is pulled up lame.
I hope he didn't throw a shoe.
I don't think so. He probably just picked up a pebble. Hold it a minute till I climb off in the seat.
Now, don't you waste any time, Chad. We ain't got that much of it.
Oh, I won't. I just want to... Oh!
What is it, Chad?
He's right feisty. Must be hurting him. Knocked me right...
A rattler. Where is he? Can you see him?
I'm right on top of him. Don't anyone move till I'm out of range. I don't want to... Oh, damn! He struck me!
Where is that son of a...
No, no! You can't! You can't see the chute! It's too late, Rusty. He got me. Oh, he got me, but good.
Chad!
Where?
Bad. In the thigh. Get your knife, Rusty. We gotta get that poison out of me.
Still got his trail, Jason?
Petered out on the shale. Could have gone any which way.
Yeah, and I know which. That was a false scent, Sheriff. He must have doubled back to kidnap my daughter, and then him and Chad met up later.
Well, where do you reckon they're headed for?
Well, sir, my spread covers east, north, and south. If they didn't go southwest, it's got to be northwest.
Well, that's a dead end. No way through the range or over old Baldy.
My hunch still is that's the way they went. And if they ever get across the mountains, we'll never find them. We got to make all the time we can.
Oh. All right, Chad, darling, all right. Rusty got all the poison out.
I got to get on my horse. Move out.
Yeah. You just rest a minute, Chad. We got time. Carrie.
What is it?
Come over here where I can talk to you.
What is it, Rusty? He's not going to...
Now, look. Ain't going to beat around the bush. That rattler stuck him, but good.
Didn't you get all the poison?
Carrie, I cut him. I sucked out all I could, but that old diamond back bit straight into the big artery. We got to get him help right soon. If anyone can help Chad... It's Lone Beaver.
Then let's get Chad on his horse and get to him.
He's in too much pain to ride, and the trip could kill him. Now, look, I'm going to hide you two back among the rocks, cover up any trail we leave. Then I'm going on with all three horses, so if your pappy gets here with his hired guns, he won't think to stop.
Leave us here alone?
Only long enough to get Lone Beaver and bring him on back to fix Chad. Now, someone's got to stay with him. Keep cold compresses on that leg. And I'll make better time alone, even leading the horses.
Is there nothing I can do?
Just keep that wound as cold as you can so the poison doesn't spread. And, Carrie, pray. Most of all, just let him see you to give him the best reason he has for living.
What you got there, Jason?
The scout found his cut on a scrub oak by the trail. Recognize it?
Yeah, give it here. Aye. That's a piece of a saddle blanket I gave Carrie last Christmas. We're on the trail, all right. Come on, let's keep moving.
Greeting, my brother.
Lone Beaver, where are you?
Where my back is safe from white man and my enemy.
Well, I'm no enemy. I'm your brother. I come in peace.
Lone Beaver, trust Rusty. But where are your companion?
A diamondback bit my brother Chad. He's in bad shape. The girl stayed on to tend him. Where are you?
If the other are not with you, do you still wish to cross mountain?
We can't till my brother Chad's ready to travel.
Are you followed?
If not yet, sooner or later.
The white man have no medicine to cool rattler poison. You think Lone Beaver can do that?
Well, I know there are Indian remedies for it. I'm asking you to use them.
You ask much, my brother in blood. I owe you my life. In the Indian way, that means you own mine. But how to save your brother is not easy.
We gotta make the try. Is there some medicine?
Only the mudstone. But first, it must be found.
Where?
The mudstone grow only in Forbidden Valley.
Well, let's go get it.
Only if Great Spirit say it may be allowed.
Well, why wouldn't it be?
That is not for Lone Beaver to say. Your brother, my brother, with all his heart, Lone Beaver wish to save him.
Where is this valley?
The sun rises now. 1 hour from here. We must pray for all sign to be right. Or else your brother will be beyond our reach in the great hunting ground.
The Madstone. It is no fiction. The stone exists. Whether whole or ground down to a powder, placed on the site of a snake bite, its astringent action tends to restrict the spread of the poison. Even President Lincoln believed in its efficacy enough so that he took his son Robert to be treated with it for a dog bite. But the question here is a little more complicated. It is not only will it heal Chad Roberts, but can it be found? And if found, in time. I shall return shortly with Act Three. In a natural rock formation, half cave, half hollow, screened by heavy undergrowth, Carrie tries to assuage the agony of the man she loves. Chad is running a high fever, racked by the rattler's poison in his veins. Ahead of them, Rusty and Lone Beaver are attempting to find something to save Chad's life. Behind them, J.B. Randall and his gunmen are on the trail to end it more suddenly and simply. And the morning sun is rising.
I can't figure where they're heading for, Sheriff. Can you?
Yeah, no, sir. Got me puzzled.
Once we get up beyond the tree line, there's nowhere to go but straight up over old Baldy. I don't know any place even a mountain goat could cross that. Only other way to go is Stone Valley. And that's a pure dead end, isn't it?
Once you pass in by the Sentinel Rocks, ain't no ways out, unless you can fly.
Why would anyone want to head for there?
You got me, Mr. Randall. Please, always give me the willies, like it was a tomb. All them echoes every time you even so much as whisper.
Yeah, maybe it's a good sign if we can bottle them up there. That's just when I'm going to make it for those Robert brothers once we catch up with them. A tomb. Come on, let's travel.
Chad. Chad, honey, what is it?
It's hot. Burning up. You got some water?
It isn't good for you to drink it. Gotta keep it for the compresses.
Where's Rusty?
He's gone to get Lone Beaver.
Why'd he leave us behind? We gotta press on.
We can't.
Why not?
Hush now. Don't you remember? You hurt him.
Oh, I'm hurting all right, but what it was... Oh, yes. Now I remember. The rattler. I had no right to...
Hush, Chad. I think you can hear them.
Ah, looky here, J.B. They stopped here by the stream to water the horses. Jack's been pretty fresh.
I think they're still here.
Yeah, they took off before dawn. Yeah, you can see where the mud's starting to cake up with the sun beating on it. They crossed the stream, all right. Tracks on the other side. Three horses. We're hot on the trail, all right.
All right, then move. I want those two boys so bad I can taste it.
Did you hear, Chad?
Yeah, I heard. Oh, Carrie, what have I done to you? We should have called out. Stop them.
Are you crazy?
No. I
was the one was crazy. I don't deserve you. No way. And now, what's gonna happen to us? We're here?
Yes. The Two Bear Rock there, our entrance to Forbidden Valley.
Oh, come on, then. Let's go.
I go no farther.
But I've got to find the madstone for my brother. How can I
will tell you. But you must search alone.
Why?
This is my God. I must not anger him. I will pray that he smile on you.
But how can I find this stone?
You will hunt. It is gray and crumbled easily to powder. If you break part of it on hard rock and put it in your mouth, it will cling there, drawing blood. You will know it if you find it.
Oh, Beaver, I haven't time to spend hunting. My brother is dying. You have to help me find it.
We could both die if we enter.
Why?
Way in is only way out. We could be trapped.
Well, we'll take that chance. Come on.
From now on, better hold to talk.
Why?
We are not alone.
Who else is here?
The dead. We must not disturb the ancestors.
This is a burial ground?
Here lie the ashes of my tribe.
Moon Beaver, now you can't wake the dead.
The dead. The dead. The dead.
I warn you, warn you. Let the dead sleep.
Shouldn't have left the horses. If J.B. and his posse catch up with us, we're dead men.
Dead or alive, we are only men.
Now, where is this madstone?
Patience, my brother. If it were easy to find, why would it have magic?
Sheriff, you're certain sure they went into this valley?
Yes, sir, J.B., anywhere else it turned, they'd have left tracks.
All right, then, let's go get them.
Ain't no need, Mr. Randall. All as we got to do is wait for them to come out.
Now, what does that mean?
Well, this here valley's sheer rock. Ain't a mite of shade or water. Under this sun, how long could a man last? The Indians call it the Forbidden Valley. We got a better name. We call it the Stone Bottle. Because once you get in it, there's only one way out.
Well, they could hole up there till after dark and maybe slip by us.
No way. It's maybe 120 degrees in this sun. They can't afford to wait for dark.
Ah, I have it.
The madstone?
You see, the god smile on us.
Well, then let's get back to the horses and get out of here.
Chad Roberts! Rusty! We have you trapped! Wherever you are! Give up! Give up! Give up!
Lone Beaver, what are we going to do? Are you sure there's no other way out?
No other way. This is judgment of Great Spirit.
He is a kind God. Why should he move against us?
How can I say?
There's no other way out?
Not unless he can help us. Or send us...
What is it?
Maybe a sign. Because I pray to him with all my heart. What happens to sun?
What? I don't know. Is that a cloud?
A cloud, only shadow, sun. This is... my ancestor tell of this.
What?
Of the coming of the great bear who swallow the sun. Look how he has bitten at it already.
Well, you're right. It's like something was eating it.
The great spirit punish me because I violated taboo.
No, he's not punishing you or us. He's helping.
How?
Don't you see? Now, I've read about this. We call it an eclipse or something. And it's total. The sun will be covered so it'll look like night.
That way we can slip by them and get back and save my brother.
Sheriff, what's the Sam Hill's going on here?
With the posse, J.B. They done took off.
Well, what for?
You see what's happening to the son. They don't like him.
Well, they better like it, or by Harry, they'll find out they should have.
You can't blame them. Some are just downright superstitious. Nobody likes this here valley. And the others, nobody wants much to be caught on this mountain after dark.
Well, you said we wouldn't have to wait till then.
But look what's happening to the sun.
Oh, that'll pass. It's only the moon getting in front of it or something. They call it an eclipse.
I'm going to tell you something, Mr. Randall. You can call it what you want, but in my book, it's a judgment of God. I ain't never seen anything like it. And don't tell me you have.
Well, of course not, but I've read about it.
Well, I don't live by no books, just by hard horse sense. I'm joining the rest of the boys.
Why, you fool, where are you going?
Away from you. I got enough to answer for without staying by you and riding my way straight down into hell.
Come back here!
I'm right here, honey.
Oh, it's hard to see you. I must be real bad off.
It's not you, Chad, darling.
But it's like twilight and getting darker.
I know.
What's happening? Don't feel like a storm.
I don't know for sure, Chad. I think it's an eclipse.
What?
It's where the moon gets in front of the sun and blots it out.
How can that happen?
I can't explain it scientifically. Anyways, it's not how I read it.
I don't follow.
I think this is a sign from God. And I don't think my daddy, cruel and vindictive as he is, can stand against it.
Are we nearly there?
Yes. We are ready to leave Forbidden Valley.
Well, then hurry. The sun's about ready to come out again.
Just hold it right there! And you, Rusty, I got you in my sights. You make one move, and I promise one dead man, if not the both of you.
You go, Rusty. I cover and follow.
But
I said I owe you my life. Go, save your brother, Chad. Go.
We're two against one.
But he is hidden, and we are in open. Go.
Chad? Carrie? It's me, Rusty.
Oh, thank the Lord you're here. With the sun blotted out like that, it's been a crazy time. First and last eclipse I ever hoped to live through.
That's over by now. How's Chad?
Not so good. Where's Lone Beaver?
Well, I don't know. All I do know is I got the madstone. I gotta find me a rock to powder it. Get it on Chad's wound fast as we can. How are you feeling now, Chad?
Tolerable, Brother Rusty. I'm weak, but that old madstone just sucked the fever right out. Just like the Lone Beaver said.
Where is he?
Oh, I don't know. It's getting close on to real dark. He ought to be back by now. Unless
what?
Nothing for you to worry about. Main thing is you licked that rattler sting. Now,
what is it?
Listen.
Yes, Miss Randall.
Who's that on your saddle horn? Oh, it's Daddy.
Lone Beaver, sorry, Miss Carey. It was his life, or Rusty, or mine. The Great Spirit, read in the sand. It must be his.
He's dead?
Yes, ma'am. Rusty, help me lift him down.
Oh, okay. What happened?
He stepped out. He had clean shot at you. There must be one dead man. Better it him.
I'm sorry, Carrie.
I'm not. He's been asking for it all his life. What happened to the posse?
Well, maybe the eclipse scared him off. Don't reckon most of them had much heart for this chase anyway.
Now what?
Yeah, with J.B. gone, no reason any more for any of us to take out. Lone Beaver, I want to thank you for my life. And Chad's, your debt sure is paid.
Between us, there is no debt, my brother. We are still blood brother. I will help you make Trava so you can bring J.B. home. Then we say goodbye.
Why must you say goodbye?
We go different path.
Maybe not. Maybe our path is yours.
Now, what are you saying, Carrie? You own the whole spread now.
I don't want to live on what was stolen from others. Why can't I just take what you took from Daddy as my fair share? And once we bury him, the three of us can take out across the hills a lone beaver and start a new life. Chad, would you like that?
I'm just so grateful to be alive again. It's anything you say, Carrie.
Just so long as you'd marry me the same.
You know what, Don?
No, Chad. What?
I don't think it was any old moon that got in front of the sun and blacked it out at just the right moment. I think it was God. And he just took time to reach out a finger and blot it out long enough to see us all home safe.
The Viper, the Diamondback, call him what you will, is seldom urged to action. And even then, his poison is not as deadly as legend would allow. Even without the Madstone, Chad probably would have recovered, as indeed he did. The moral of this story, if it must have one, is that people are far more lethal than any animal. I'll be back shortly. Like things wrapped up neatly, the marriage of Chad Roberts and Carrie Randall was the event of the season. The matter of the robbery was lost entirely since complete restitution was made, and the money belonged to the bride. Anyway, Sheriff Jason left the county precipitously, and the rest of JB's guns for hire dispersed easily, since there was no price for their services. The total eclipse of the sun, in this instance, reflected the finger of God. Our cast included Kristoffer Tabori, Russell Horton, Catherine Byers, and Ian Martin. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown. And now, a preview of our next tale.
Young man, there is no other way.
Ah, so you are all blind.
Give me your hand. I will guide it to the edge of a post of wood that has always been in the center of this cave. Can you feel it?
Yes, I can.
Now, as you move your hand, count the cuts in the wood. Go on.
2, 4, 5, 7.
She's gone, gone.
12, 13, 14.
14 generations have left their mark there. 14 generations have kept together, farming, weaving, building, all by sound and by touch. There is nothing else.
Good Lord. This is the country of the blind.
This is E.G. Marshall inviting you to return to our mystery theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time,
pleasant dreams.
Ultimate in sleep, unique.
extra thick cushion for heavenly comfort on top. Ultra firm support inside. Perfect sleeper pillow soft. Firm as it feels good.
Be a perfect sleeper. Buy a perfect sleeper.